Hello, I'm being frank with you. If you go on Facebook and you see an advert for a robot vacuum cleaner and it says this is a V5S, don't buy it, because what they send you is nothing like a V5S. I got this box. Clean robot. It is not a V5S. It's plastic rubbish. It has a little red light and it does do some vacuuming, but it does not have clift detection. It does not have sweeping brushes at the edges. Really, it's junk. So, as an alternative, I bought one of these. Robot Center in Austria. Of course, it comes from Austria. It must be good. So I'm going to do a little bit of unboxing today. So I'm going to get my trusty Swiss Army knife. Why is everything so continental? Robot vacuum cleaners from Austria, Swiss Army knife, presumably from Switzerland. So we'll open it up. This is a Eufy Light Up Your Life vacuum cleaner. You can always see that something comes from not the United Kingdom when they supply you one of these. United Kingdom, Great Britain socket, and then presumably European, Austrian. It's not like Germany. Huh. So, box inside a box. Egg box. Nearly upside down. It's better. And certainly a lot more professional than the other thing that we had. Ah, it's even a little bit bigger. And heavier. There are a lot of brushes, like small helicopters in here. And also another thing, this plastic rubbish from China did not have. It said it would have a docking station, but no, it did not. You had to recharge batteries all the time. Ah yes, this is so much better than the other one. It's even got wheels that can change from moving from a floor to a carpet. I really should take out the instructions and find out what I'm supposed to do. So, in the box we have the robot vacuum cleaner. I guess this is a cleaning brush. Oh, a remote control. This just gets better and better. Docking station. HEPA filter. Some other type of filter. And the bit that makes it all work. Power cable. And I hope this fits in here. Yeah, it's good. So, paperwork. Did we light up your life? Well, I don't know yet. But it's quite good that they give you 5 different telephone numbers here if you've got any problems. I have already made a complaint on PayPal, which they have escalated about the other Chinese robot vacuum cleaner. Because I really want my money back, or I want something in return, because I think trading standards, they have said that they have to send you the thing that they say they are selling you. Anyway, what have we got here? Quick start guide. Ah, Schnellstartanleitung. That's good. Also in French. And a quick start guide in pictures. That's like buying something from IKEA. I think we use this one. Yeah. Bedienungsanleitung, ist gut. So, so many different languages. Take Robo back and the charging base out and remove plastic film. I guess they mean this. Flip Robo back over and snap on the side brushes. Flip over. 1, 2. So, they give you 4 brushes, that's good. So they give you 2 spare brushes. I guess these will just Oh, snap into place. It's good. Number three. Place the charging base against the wall on hard level surface. Need to find somewhere to put this. And against the wall. Need to choose carefully. This is not the best room to choose for an experiment because there are too many obstacles, too much rubbish lying around. We're having so much work done in the house that no room has all the things it should have in it. It just has everything from everywhere else. That did not make much sense, but I know what I mean. So we miss this one, we take it to another room. Remove objects within 1 meter of the left and right side and within 2 meters of the front. Okay. Connect to the wall, attach back to the charging base by aligning its charging pins with the charging pins on the base. These must be the charging pins on the base. So when we go to do this point, we put it like this. First power switch on the side of the RoboVac. This one. Press this symbol on RoboVac. Or on the remote control. I wonder if the remote control already has batteries. No, it does not feel, it's too light. Those look like the very small. I don't think we have any of those at the moment. Anyway, no problem. We check on this later. So I'm going to go to another room where it is okay for all these different directions. Let's go. Go to another room. I say we. I have my trusty cameraman son with me today. I missed this piece before. Take it off. Go back to the instructions. It says there are no objects in this room because we have just had some work done to a window in the ceiling, and we've been cleaning in here this morning, and so there's no furniture for this to get stuck on. So I go back to plug into the wall. Attach RoboVac to the charging base by aligning the pins. Okay. Press the power switch on the side of the RoboVac. I think maybe we need to push this one first. And then here. And then press here. Yeah, let's move! Yeah, this is a lot more professional than the other one. And a lot bigger. That takes some good jumps every now and again. Oh, I'm going to have to close the door. Oh no, it's not coming this way at all. My first thought is that it is being very logical. It's got to a point and now it's going to go up and down, I guess. We'll see. So it goes along, turns, and now, yeah, so it's going to go up and down, and up and down, yeah. And I like these little sweeping brushes because that will get into the edges of the floor. Now I've decided not to do what I thought. Okay. Look at the difference in size between the Chinese rubbish and this. It's just no comparison. Why did it stop in somewhere? It does look like it's being a bit chaotic in it when it travels. I don't know, when it hits the wall it always makes me laugh. Again, why did it stop and turn? I don't understand. It's really good that this can go up on top of the carpet. course, billing is, I'm very impressed with what it's doing. It doesn't get stuck the way the other one does. It's got some weight to it, so it gives me the feeling that it's a good product. I think we leave it running for a little while just to see how it does in here. But I suppose it's not really a very good test of how good it cleans, because this room was already cleaned this morning. My son cleaned it after the man had been fixing the window. So I want to leave it for a while. I guess because it's brand new, the battery will not be fully charged. So I expect it to run down. So the big test here is, before it dies completely, does it go back and redock on the docking station? So we just let it run until we don't feel it moving anymore and come back and see it later. So we found a couple of small pencil batteries and put them inside, and it works because it shows it. Well, it shows a time, not the time. What I really want to see is when you press this button here, which looks like it sends it back to the docking station. Does it send it back to the docking station? Let's go find out. So it's been running about for a little while, I think maybe over half an hour. Doesn't show any signs of running out of I was going to say petrol, but you know what I mean. So I'm going to wait till it's far away from the docking station and then press this button and see what happens next. Okay, I think that's far enough. 3, 2, 1, go! Ah, there's a tune. And it's going home. I am so impressed with this. Probably better if I don't have a cable in my head. That is so clever. It makes me think you could just have it running around the house for the whole day. Our house is maybe not so easy to clean with all the different things we have, but well, we can try that experiment later on. I'm going to have lunch now, but after lunch I want to try the it's called Clift Detection. In other words, it gets to the top of the stairs and doesn't go like a lemming over the top and commit suicide. It actually stops and turns around and goes back again. So we'll try that after I've had some lunch. Just one more thing while I see it on the screen here. It actually shows you on there that the Eufy is back at its docking station. It shows a little house with the electric plug on it. Okay, lunchtime. I was going to make pancakes, but we have no eggs. My wife is going to the supermarket on her way home, but that does not help me right now. So I went on the internet and I looked for a recipe for no egg pancake. I didn't think I'd find one, but of course you go on the internet and look for one thing and you find 10 million. So I have a recipe for no egg pancakes, and really it's not much different from any other pancake recipe, except it has no egg in it. Flour, baking powder, milk, butter. I take it the butter substitutes in some way for the egg in terms that it holds all the other ingredients together. And I put in a little teaspoon of vanilla just for the taste. So I've whipped it up in the Blendtec so that it is on the batter setting, and I got this mixture. So the pan is warm. Let's see what happens when we pour it in. I don't like to make big pancakes. I prefer small pancakes. That way, if it's a disaster, it's not a big disaster. Certainly makes the right noise. Let's see if they cook. That was not a very good attempt for the first one. I think I let the others cook a little bit longer before I try to turn them. The first pancakes did not work out perfectly. They didn't work out good at all. And I think most batches of pancakes that I make, it's always the same thing. Maybe I rush it and I don't have the pan as hot as it should be to get started, because afterwards they seem to work out okay. These ones, the no egg pancakes, they seem to be a bit more almost like they're crispy on the outside. I haven't tried any of them to find out what they're like on the inside, but certainly they cook nicely and they have a nice brown finish. To do the old, here's one I made earlier. The ones that I'm keeping warm in the oven, for example. This is one of the first ones, and this was not me eating it. But this is one of the later ones, and you see it's a nice finish to it. Slightly glazed, which shows that it is a bit crispier than perhaps you would want it to be. But they seem to be okay. We're now on to the fourth or maybe fifth set of pancakes. And they're coming along. They cook a lot more slowly than the egg ones, I think. I don't know why. But it is working out. Of course, the real test will be when I give them to my sons for lunch and they say, "Dad, these are fantastic!" Or maybe not. I'll let you know. Well, I suppose when you cook something, if everybody eats it, it is some form of success. I got no complaints about the pancakes. They did have that slight glaze on the surface, and it made it ever so slightly crunchy. Not crunchy like cornflakes, just a crispness, you know, like icing on a cake maybe. And well, the boys ate them, and so they're quite happy. I had the one which was left over, and it was slightly bigger than the others because it was the last one. And I had the raspberry jam on it, and it was very nice. Raspberry jam because we have no maple syrup. But the order is in with my wife, who is currently at the supermarket, and we will have maple syrup for the next time. So I consider that a success. Now I'll go back and see how the vacuum cleaner is working. So I think we can say we have proved that the cliff detection system in the Eufy works really well. I actually used the gizmo to direct it straight at the top of the stairs, and it knew where it was, and it stopped itself and turned around a little bit and eventually turned away from the top of the stairs completely. So I am impressed with that. Also, this little gizmo, you can actually drive it like a remote control car. Here I am in big kid mode, but it's good. And you can just press the button and it stops. And then the fun thing is to press this and tell it to go home. I think it's getting a little bit dizzy. That was a really good test, because we were about 12, 13 meters away from the docking station, and it managed to find its way all the way there. Okay, no great obstacles to go around, but it still managed to find its way, and now it's docking and charging. I want to move it to a different room now to see if it works under the beds. I'm not going to video that though. So it's good, I really like it. The other thing I want to do, just while it's sitting on the docking station, is see how easy it is to empty it out, to clean it. They say in the instructions that you just press here. Oh, that is easy. And then it opens up like a clamshell. And you can see the dust it has picked up. That's pretty good. And these filters, you can take them out and wash them One thing I thought was quite funny in the instruction manual, it says to clean the filters, take them out and vacuum them. I suppose everybody will have a normal Hoover vacuum, especially if they have stairs like ours. I'm not going to empty it out. Just see how easy it goes in again. Yeah, that's really good. I like this. This is the best thing I've bought for a long time.
So the Goofy is now sitting at his docking station charging, and I still to try and understand what the different lights mean on top. It has colored lights, blue, green, red. Red is obviously when something is wrong, but the blue and green, still not quite sure what they mean. And tomorrow it'll have more adventures in different parts of the house. Today, the only bad thing we had was where I left it in a room where there's too many cables, and I could hear it wasn't very happy about something. When I went in, it had sucked up one of the small cables, but it just, when I picked it up, I was able to take it back out. It wasn't jammed inside or anything like that. So, I'm very pleased with it. It's a good purchase, certainly a lot better than anything you can get from China. I recommend it. Eufy. EUFY. Eufy.